Hey campers, what an amazing week we had this week. I enjoyed meeting so many of you. You guys are the coolest people on the planet. And I thank you for all the love and all that. It was just a great week. I enjoyed most of all seeing what God did in your hearts this week. It was truly, truly an amazing week. So thank you for coming this week. And as promised, I wanted to make this video and share with you the 5 tips that's gonna keep your faith fired up. It's so important, guys, because it's not a momentary faith. What happened to you here at camp, what God did in your heart wasn't a camp thing, it was a God thing. God just happened to do it at camp. And so I want to give you these tips to keep your faith alive every day in the Lord. And many of you, for the first time, your faith was ignited, right? For the very first time, and you got fired up. And I want you to stay fired up. Many of you reignited your passion, and God reignited your heart for Him, and you're on this journey now. Now you're like, how do I keep it going, Paul? Well, this is it. These are the 5 tips I want to give you that will help you keep your faith on fire. So number one is this: read your Bible. Read your Bible, guys. Start in the Gospel of John. Start reading about who Jesus is, what He did. Read about His commandments. Read about His promises. Read about the principles. And as we read about what Jesus did and what Jesus said, we're able to take that in and say, wow, that's how I live. That's how I want to be more like Christ. What did Jesus do here? What did Jesus do in this situation? And then you know the whole story, and you can begin to go deeper into the scriptures and go read Psalms and read Proverbs for wisdom and read Paul, the epistles of Paul, like Galatians and Ephesians and Colossians and all that, and be able to share and know in your heart that says, this is how God is leading me, and these are some things that God wants me to know for my life. And if you'll read your Bible every day, your faith will stay on fire. Number two is prayer. And prayer isn't just talking to God, it's also listening to God. It's finding those quiet times, those moments, and it's not just a set time. It's not an hour, it's not 2 hours, it's simply going throughout your day. And when you find time to pray and just talk to the Lord, just like you were walking down the hallway of your school with a friend, you take time to talk with them. You don't just have set times with your friends and say, hey, I'm only gonna meet with you for an hour, and we're gonna chat, and I'm gonna do most of the talking, and you're gonna listen, and then maybe I'll let you get a word in edgewise. It's really about a conversation. It's really about saying, Lord, all throughout my day, I'm gonna take time to talk with you, and I'm gonna take time to listen to you. And if you'll take time every day to say, Lord, here are my requests, here's my worship, here's my praise, and also taking time to say, Lord, what do you want to say into my life? What do you want to say into me that will help me better follow you? What do you want to say about me as a person? What do you want to say about me as your child? And if you'll do that, I'm telling you what, when you hear the Lord whisper in your voice and whisper into your heart, it's going to be tremendous, and that fire is just going to go, it's going to blow up big time. The third tip I want to give you is this, is finding a community of believers. Finding a church is so important. Being in fellowship with other people, having corporate worship, being together. Now look, it's not going to be like worship maybe here at camp, but that's okay. God doesn't have one form of worship that He enjoys. He enjoys all kinds of worship. He enjoys hymns. He enjoys all these things. So take time, find a good church. Find a church that preaches God's word. Find a church that has worship. Find a church that enjoys reading the Bible together. But most of all, find a place that you can connect with other believers, people who want to fire up your faith, people who want to encourage you, people who want to encourage you to follow the Lord. And it's so important that you do that, because you know what? You take one stick on fire, put it with a bunch of sticks on fire, you got a bonfire. You got a big lit fire there that you can enjoy and stay warm and stay fired up in your faith. The fourth tip is this, is that when you get into this community of people, and whether you do it in the church or outside of the church, find a way to serve. Find a way to use your gifts. Find a way to use these gifts and talents that God has given you. And that can be anything. That can be anything from cooking. That can be drawing. It can be singing. You can join the worship team. You can serve and set up chairs. Go find, if you're in a church already, go to your youth pastor and say, hey, pastor, what can I do? If you don't have a youth pastor, go to your senior pastor and say, pastor, what can I do? How can I serve the church? How can the way God has designed me help and serve and show off what God's done in my heart? What can I do? And if you'll do that, I'm telling you, the more you serve, the more you give, the more you do these things, your faith is going to get fired up big time. And the fifth and last tip is this: share your story. The more you hear your mouth say the things that God did in your heart, it's going to fire you up. It's going to be like, God really did this. This is an amazing thing. And if you'll share your story, you don't have to go into everything. You don't have to know everything about the Bible. You don't have to know everything about God. All you have to do is share your story. Like the blind man that Jesus healed, his story was simple. Once I was blind, but now I see. So share your story, share what God did in your heart this week, and share it ongoing, what God does in your heart. Post it on your social media. Find places to share God's story. Say, God is amazing, look what he's done. He's done this in my family, he's done this in my life. And if you'll simply share your story, I'm telling you, your faith will stay on fire. And that's what we want, right? All right, well guys, that is it. Those are my Fire 5 tips for you to keep your faith on fire. Once again, an amazing week this week, guys. I look forward to talking with you guys some more here on YouTube. And I love you guys. Have a great week. Feel free to leave comments down below, and I will see you guys next time. They can't put it out. Can't put it out.